morning students. Today I am here to explain the second poem in Morning Dew. The poem is written by K.K. Daruwala. The present poem in Morning Dew, it is taken from The Scarecrow and the Ghost, which was published in 2004. The poem, it is set in the world of nature. In Morning Dew, this poem shows the world through eyes of a scarecrow. When we read the poem, we can come to know that the poet has described a fresh and beautiful morning and a scarecrow. This is the background of the poem in Morning Dew. It is written by K.K. Daruwala. It has been taken from The Scarecrow and the Ghost, which was published in 2004. In this poem, the poet has described a fresh and beautiful morning as well as a scarecrow. Now we will understand the poem stanza wise. Now let's understand the first stanza of the poem. In morning dew, the scarecrow combs his hair. In morning light, the scarecrow looks so spry. You know he has had a good night's sleep. He is now in a fitter state to spy on shouting monkeys and the porcupine. He gets to see everything all the time, except his shadow which lazes about till the evening snuffs the fellow out. This is the first stanza of the poem in Morning Dew. Now let's understand it. In Morning Dew, the scarecrow combs his hair. In morning light, the scarecrow looks so spry. You know he has had a good night's sleep. In early morning, due to having dew in the atmosphere, the hair of scarecrow, it seems they are combed. Besides that, as at night time the scarecrow has enough sleep, so now he is in the fitter state. Fitter, it means he is now energetic for his work, and work of the scarecrow is to spy. It means to detect, to look after. So in these four lines, in morning dew the scarecrow combs his hair, in morning light the scarecrow looks so spry. When there is a morning, due to having good sleep at night, now the scarecrow is so spry. Spry, it means alert, very careful. So in early morning, due to appearance of dew, the combs of the hair of scarecrow, they seems they are combed. The scarecrow is very alert. Due to having good night sleep, now the scarecrow is energetic to spy on shouting monkeys and the porcupine. The function, the work of the scarecrow is to spy, is to detect, shouting all the time at monkeys and the porcupine, not allowing them to enter in the field, in farm. He gets to see everything all the time. He has to observe all the time. He does not allow porcupine, monkeys, birds to enter into the field, except his shadow which lazes about till the evening snuffs the fellow out. The scarecrow, one of his limitations, that as it is a non-living thing, he is not able to bend. And as he is not able to bend, he is not able to see his own shadow. And till the evening snuffs the fellow out. Snuffs, it means end. Till evening, he continuously does his duty to spy. This is about the first stanza of the poem in Morning Dew. Now second stanza of the poem. Whether he sees the seasons come and go, is a thing you and I may never know. But busy as he is, he keeps an eye on all the birds, traffic passing by. Some questions always bother him, how seasons come and go, the way the seasons to and fro. He doesn't know who is getting in, summer, autumn or the snow, something he should surely know. This is the second stanza of the poem in Morning Dew. In the present stanza, the poet has said that the scarecrow is busy in his function. He is busy in his work. And the function, the work of the scarecrow is to keep an eye. It means to spy on the birds flying over the field or the animals. So the scarecrow is all the time busy in his work, and he is an efficient worker. He works efficiently. He is busy all the time. But during this time, some questions bother him. Some of the questions are there in his mind, and these questions are how seasons come and go, how different seasons come and go. Another question that also bother him, that which season is getting in. It means what is the order of the season, whether summer is going to come or autumn or the winter. So some of the questions they bother the scarecrow, they were that which seasons come and go and which season is going to come. What is the order of the seasons? These are the questions that bother the scarecrow. In spite of being busy in his work to keep an eye over the birds and animals, some of the questions that bother him. This is mentioned in the second stanza of the poem. Now let's understand the third stanza of the poem. He knows he shivers in the cold, and in the summer he will fry. Do seasons come up from the ground, or do they drop down from the sky? Are questions that have bothered him, answers do not dribble in. To keep questions out and answers in, he bolts his upper story's door. Then he wonders why on earth his head goes round in circles for. Why seasons circle round and round like oxen on a threshing floor. This is the last stanza of the poem in Morning Dew. In the first two lines, he knows he shivers in the cold, and in the summer he will fry. Earlier I have said that the scarecrow, it is a non-living thing. It is a lifeless object. But in the present poem, the poet has personified the scarecrow. And here the poet has used the poetic device. It means figures of speech personification. What is meant by personification? Personification, it is a figure of speech in which inanimate object, it means a non-living thing, it has been given a human quality. Here we can see, he knows he shivers in the cold. Now the scarecrow, it is a non-living thing. Then also he is given the quality that he shivers in the cold. He shivers in winter season like us. So that is, he is given the human quality. So in cold season, the scarecrow shivers, and in summer season, he will fry. Do seasons come up from the ground, or do they drop down from the sky, are questions that have bothered him. Even in second stanza, we have seen that some of the questions that bother the scarecrow, that how seasons come and go, which seasons come first, what is the order of the seasons. Even in the last stanza also, some of the questions that bother the scarecrow, that do seasons come up from the ground, or the seasons drop down from the sky. It means whether the seasons come up from the ground, or the seasons drop down from the sky. The answers, the scarecrow doesn't get answers of these questions. That is why he decided to search his upper stories door. Here the upper stories door, it means his brain. he wants to search, he wants to close his brain so that such questions, they are out of his mind. Then he wonders why on earth his head goes round in circles for wild season, circle round and round like oxen on a threshing floor. In this last line, we have seen that the scarecrow wonders that why his head is circling, why there is a round and round of the, why there is a seasons cycle of seasons. And in the last line, the poet has used simile. Simile, it is also one of the figures of speech in which there is a comparison between two objects by using the word like or as. Here in the last line, we have seen that while season circle round and round, and this season circle, it has been compared with oxen on a threshing floor. So it is a figures of speech simile. This is about the second poem in Morning Dew. When you read the poem line to line, you can find out some of these two figures of speech or two poetic devices, that is personification and simile. Simile you can find in the last line, whereas numbers of time the poet has used this poetic device or figures of speech, personification. Personification, I repeat, these both figures of speech. Personification, it is a figures of speech in which inanimate object or non-living thing is given the human quality. And second, simile, comparison between two objects or two persons by using the word like or as. This is about the second poem in Morning Dew.